May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit. So I want to talk a bit, if you don't mind, the grace, the love, and the fellowship. And we'll end there. What is grace? Charis. The loose translation is unmerited favor. But my problem is that whenever people hear about favor, what comes to your mind is material things. But favor is much more than that. Grace is favor, merited favor. So take this. Grace is any good thing you have, others don't have, but they need. Any good thing you have, or any good thing you can do, others can't, but they need. That's grace. It may be material, it may be non-material. You read, how many of us here read Arrow of God? There is an interesting woman in that character. What's her name? Ihuoma, right? Is it not Arrow of God? The concubine. Is the concubine by Elechi Amadi. There is an interesting character there. Her name is Ihuoma. What is her story? When two people are fighting, when two women are quarreling that will lead to fight, what will happen? Ihuoma will simply carry one and say, "Hey, Mama Chidimma, come. I want to borrow palm oil," because she's such a nice woman that everybody wants to be her friend. She says, "Come, I want to borrow palm oil from you." She will drag you out. The other person will remain. Now, if this person remains, you don't see who you go quarrel with. Will she quarrel? It's only a mad person that can be talking to himself. So she has the grace of bringing peace. In other words, where she is, you can't fight. That's grace. There are some people that, you know now, somebody can insult you now. You didn't hear the insult you, but there are trouble. Somebody say, "Hey, Mark, you didn't hear what the guy said? He said you're an idiot." Then you will now realize that, oh, somebody insulted you. He said you be idiot, though. You go agree. And if you are truly an idiot, you no go agree. You will now say, tell him I say he's a bastard. Then he will turn that back and say, "Hey, he added three, but he said you're an idiot, a bastard, and an orphan." Some people can cause trouble, while some people can do what? Make peace. That's our grace. He said the grace of the Lord Jesus is very specific, definite. The grace, something he has, nobody else has it. And if he didn't give it to us, we wouldn't have it. There are many instances of that. Revelation 5. John said, "And I saw a scroll with seven seals, but nobody was found in heaven or on earth that can open the scroll." What happened? I started crying. They looked everywhere, nobody was found. He started crying in hopelessness. Then one of the elders came and touched him and said, "Stop crying." He said, "We have found somebody." Who? He said, "The Lion of the tribe of Judah." Who is that? The Lord Jesus Christ. And then the hymn say, "What is the Lamb that was slain to take the scroll and to open its seals?" Because you were slain, and by your blood you have ransomed men for God from every tribe and tongue and people and nation. Only he could open that scroll. And if he didn't open that scroll, it means that things have been closed in your life. There are divine possibilities and blessings that you could never accept. It was the Lamb that opened it. That is grace. He was the only one found worthy and able to open the scroll. I pray for you this morning. Whatever only grace can open in your life, may the Lord Jesus open it for you. Because John 1 said, "From his fullness we have received grace on top of grace, or favor on top of favor, in the name of Jesus the Lord." In Genesis chapter 6 verse 8, the Bible says, if you read from verse 5, God was angry and disappointed. God had decided to wipe off the whole earth. But verse 8 says, Noah found favor with the Lord. Another translation shows, but Noah found grace with God. Even though God had decided that every human being, I don't know what happened, Noah found grace. That's why it is called favor. He did not go any contest, so he just found it. And what is that grace Noah carried? It was the grace of an opportunity for anybody. Everybody say anybody. And everybody to do what? To escape a catastrophe that was going to affect everybody. That was the grace. What was the grace? Build an ark. Anybody who finds his way into that ark, even though the person is a sinner, the person is qualified to be washed away by the flood. Once you find a way into that ark, what will happen? You will be saved. But that grace, the knowledge, the revelation was known only to Noah. But unfortunately, the people of his day, they were what? Foolish. They didn't believe him. Abby? And because they did not believe him, they did not enter. So listen very well. They did not perish in the flood because of their sin. Their sin was the necessary reason for the flood, but their sin was not sufficient for their destruction. There was a way out. There was grace. All they needed to do was to listen to Noah and enter the ark, and the ark conceals your sin, and then you are saved. But they refused to enter. So they were not destroyed because they were sinners. They were destroyed because they were foolish. They didn't believe. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that anyone who believes in him should not what? Should not perish, but should do what? Have everlasting life. That you are saved. It is by the grace of believing in the Son who carries the ark of salvation, who carries what is going to save you. That is where your salvation lies. But they did not believe. That's why they got perished. Look at them. Look at Sodom and Gomorrah. God did the same thing. Abraham came. And Abraham challenged God. And God said, okay, Abraham, no problem. If I find so number of righteous people, I will spare the nation. Sodom and Gomorrah was looking for one person with grace, favor. Unfortunately, none was found. May you never live in a place or in an era where nobody is carrying grace in the name of Jesus Christ. Couldn't find. That's why Jesus said, I think in Matthew, when he preached and the cities did not respond, he said, "Woe to you, Chorazin. Woe to you, Bethsaida." He said, if the miracles done in you were done in Sodom and Gomorrah, they would have done what? They would have repented. In other words, if the grace you are seeing now was witnessed and seen by Sodom and Gomorrah, perhaps they would have changed. May you never perish where there is grace. So I didn't hear your amen. To watch full videos and get notifications for new ones, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. God bless you.
Sign up with the largest community of Catholics online. Meet new friends, chat, post pictures and videos, make and receive audios and video calls, interact with lots of priests and religions. Download the app from Google Play Store.